Hi, welcome to Paper Tales. Today I'm going to teach you how to make candle votives from clay. So to make a beautiful candle votive, we'll use some of this epoxy compound. You can take about half of it. I prefer to use a string to cut it because it's less messy. Just run a string through it. We're taking half right now. The same thing with the other compound. Let's spread some talc on the mat. Cut it through. Both of them have to be of the equal size. Try to be as specific as possible. Put some talc on your hands and start kneading these together. It'll take some time for this. Keep using a bit of talc if it starts sticking to your hands. So you still see some brown and white. We have to mix it till it's all white. It's almost white now. Roll it in your hands. Make a circle. Put some talc. And now, as you're making a pizza base or a roti, you just roll it with the rolling pin. You can decide how thick or thin you want it to be. Just keep on applying some talc to it. Try to be as even as possible. I guess this is enough. Now the straw which we used, we'll poke holes through it. This is far easier to use. Leave a little area in the center. That's gonna be our base, so we don't need holes over there. You can do different sizes of the holes. Cut a couple at the edges too. They'll look cool too. This gets a little messy. Do it on a newspaper or something if possible. That's it. Now keep this aside. These pellets you can mix up and use once again for some other project if you have any. Now this is a mold on which I'm going to mold this. So I have some cling film. Try and use this as much as possible. Keep that aside. Cover this entire mold properly and take this and put it over here. Now you can give this some shape if you want, some extra curves in between or whatever you like, however you like it, and leave it to dry. Now if you want to add color and if you're not too happy about painting, then you can add the color when we are kneading the dough, the epoxy. And if you want to paint it afterwards, later on, you can paint it later on too, once it's dried. So we'll just leave this aside over here. It'll take about 2 hours to set and be really strong. So in the meantime, I've already made something like this. So I made this lovely candle votive and I painted it green in color. And you can see I've made it really thin, and in the same way I've cut the holes in the same way. And I made another one over here, same technique, just a different shape. I made a round first, cut it through, and then cut this away aside, and then added holes to it. These holes are a bit smaller and bigger both, and then stuck both of them together, stuck both the parts together. You can use glue, it's very simple, and that's it, as simple as that.